So now let's find the angle between two lines. So just a little bit of background. When two distinct lines intersect and are non-perpendicular, their intersection forms two pairs of opposite angles. One pair is acute and the other pair is obtuse. The smaller of these angles is the angle between the two lines. We're looking for the smaller angle. If two lines have inclinations, theta 1 and theta 2, where theta 1 is less than theta 2, and theta 2 minus theta 1 is less than pi over 2, then the angle between the two lines is theta equals theta 2 minus theta 1, as shown in the figure. Use a formula for the tangent of the difference of the two lines. So that's what we're looking at. But what we're really going to use instead of that is the angle between the two lines is we're going to look at the slopes. If two perpendicular lines have slopes m1 and m2, then the tangent of the angle between the two lines is tangent of theta equals the slope of the second minus the slope of the first divided by 1 plus m1 times m2. So we're going to use that formula in order to find the angle between two lines. So this is the one I'm highlighting. So let's try that out. Find the angle between 2x minus y equals 4 and 3x plus 4y equals 12. So the very first thing you need to do is find the slope of both equations. And so for the first one, you're going to get negative y equals negative 2x plus 4, or dividing by negative 1, you find that the slope is going to be 2, m1. Then let's try the second one. So find the slope of that one. So that's 4y equals negative 3x plus 12 divided by 4. So we find that m2 is going to be negative 3 over 4. So now we're just going to use the formula tangent of theta equals the absolute value of the second slope minus the first slope over 1 plus m1 times m2. So let's substitute in here. So notice it's always going to be a positive value. So m2 is negative 3 fourths minus 2 over 1 plus 2 times negative 3 fourths. So I just substitute everything inside. And then so we're going to find, so just to get a common denominator, negative 3 fourths minus 2 times 4 is 8 over 4. And then all over my common denominator, let's see, 2 goes into 4 2 times. So I'm going to get 2 over 2 minus 3 halves for my denominator. And so this ends up being negative 11 over 4 over negative 1 over 2. Or if we simplify this, so we're going to multiply by 2, we end up with 11 over 2. So we're looking for the tangent of theta equals 11 over 2. So we're going to do theta equals, so to solve for theta, we do the arctangent of 11 over 2. And so you plug that in your calculator, you'll get 1.3909 or 79.7 degrees. So you are going to look for the radians and you're also going to look for degrees. So try this example here. Find the angle between negative 4x plus 5y equals 10 and 3x plus 2y equals negative 5. So you just find that the first equation, the slope is positive 4/5. And then the second equation is negative 3/2 for the slope. And then you apply the formula. You find that the answer is 23 over 2. Or the angle is 1.4841 in radians and 85 degrees in degrees. So let's take a look at the distance between a point and a line. Finding the distance between a line and a point not on the line is an application of perpendicular lines. The distance of the length of the perpendicular line segment joining the point and the line shown as d to the right. So remember the distance formula. Distance equals the square root of x2 minus x1, and that's squared, plus y2 minus y1 squared. So that's all we're using. But the formula can be written in terms of the coordinates x1 and y1 and the coefficients of a, b, and c in the general form of the equation of a line ax plus by plus c equals 0. So this is the formula we are going to use. The distance between the point x1, y1 and the line ax, by plus c is the distance equals the absolute value of a times x1 plus b times y1 plus c all over the square root of a squared plus b squared. So we're going to apply that formula. Find the distance between the point 4, 1 and the line y equals 2x plus 1. So what we want to do first is we want to set the equation equal to 0. And so I'm going to go ahead and move everything to the left side. So I'm going to subtract 2x, subtract 1, and put it on this side. So it's set equal to 0. So we have negative 2x plus y minus 1 equals 0. So a is negative 2, b is 1, and c is negative 1 here. Then we have our x and our y. So again, that formula, the distance equals a times x1 plus b times y1 plus c all over the square root of a squared plus b squared. And so let's just plug that all in. So the distance equals the absolute value of a is negative 2 times 4 plus 1, the b value, times 1, and then c is minus 1. And that's all over the square root of a squared, negative 2 squared, plus 1 squared. So then we simplify that. We find that, well, 1 minus 1 is 0, so we get negative 8, or just 8 in the numerator. 2 times 2 is 4 plus 1, so it's 8 over root 5. And so that's the distance between the points. It's approximately, so it's 8 over root 5, or 3.58 units. So try this example below. Find the distance between the point 5, negative 1, and the line y equals negative 3x plus 2. So trying that out, you would find that you would get 12 over root 10, or approximately 3.79 units. Now, here's just a second example of finding the distance between a point and a line. So we'll just do this together. So the next one, what we need to do is, again, change this, set it equal to 0. This is our x and our y. So this is a, b, c. And so we're going to plug it into the formula. Distance equals 7 times 2 plus 5 times negative 1 plus 13 all over the square root of 7 squared plus 5 squared. And so you would find you'd get 14 minus 5 plus 13 all over the square root of 49 plus 25, which is 74. So then the numerator you would find ends up being 22 over square root of 74, which is approximately 2.56 units. So try the next example down here. Find the distance between the point 3, 2 and the line negative 3x plus 5y equals negative 2. So trying that out, you should have gotten 3 over root 34, or approximately 0.51 units is the distance.